So let's take what we now know about series and parallel resistors and combine them into a circuit. So if I give you a circuit that has a battery and has a resistance here, for example, and has a resistance here, and then another resistance here, and at this point, we actually connect our load. And what is a load? A load is any device that draws current. So let me just put some numbers in here. How about we use 20 ohms, 40 ohms, and 80 ohms. And let's see, how about we use 10 volts? Okay, so this circuit, if I continue on with additional circuits, I'm going to create myself a bit of a mess. So there was an individual named Thevenin, and Thevenin said that, you know, there's a way to reduce the complexity of circuits with internal source voltages and resistances, for example, to something much simpler. And it's called a Thevenin equivalent. And so the equivalent is, let's reduce if we look at a Thevenin equivalent, it looks like, just like, give me a source, give me an internal resistance, and then use that to connect your loads to it. So this, R Thevenin, has to be calculated. And this, V Thevenin, has to be calculated. Even though we're looking at this circuit here, okay, even though we're looking at this circuit here, we need to reduce this to this. Now, one of the things you'll note here is that this does not have a play in the circuit analysis. Why? It could be anything. I don't know what the load is. So if you're going to calculate it for every single load that comes along, you're going to have a problem. Let's just remove it for now, get an equivalent circuit, and then we'll put a load on it later. So the first thing we do with Thevenin is we actually do that. We remove the load. Now we have a circuit that looks like this. It's not complete yet. We need to figure out what is the voltage that I'm looking at here, and what is the resistance that is in series with that particular voltage. So the first thing Thevenin says is, okay, Len, let's just make these steps down here. Remove the load. Okay, gone. We've done that. Two, he says, now we're going to calculate what is the Thevenin resistance. So what he says is short the source voltages. So what is a short? Essentially, when current has a path to follow, we normally put a resistor in there because you don't want all the charge to run as fast as it can. If it does, you're basically destroying your voltage source because it will run as much as it can, as fast as it can. So what we do is we put a resistance in. But sometimes you'll see circuits where people have, for whatever reason, or something has fallen across it, a piece of wire or something with essentially no resistance will fall across a source, and that wipes it out. Doesn't matter what you've got for resistance in there. 0 ohms times anything in parallel is zero, okay? So that is called a short circuit. You've given a shorter path for the current to follow rather than through the resistance. So the concept of shorting is essentially putting a wire through there, and when you have a short circuit, when you have a wire with no resistance in it, so if V equals IR and R is zero, and Z, then V will be zero, regardless of how big, even if it's infinity, I is. So in this case here, we're going to take a wire and short our battery, and when we do that, there'll be no resistance there. So what does that look like? It looks like this. Okay. So now that that's shorted, what we do is take our eyeball and look into the circuit. And now what I want to do is see what's going on here. So, hey, our friend series and parallel circuits. What we have here is 20 ohms in parallel with 80 ohms in series with 40 ohms. First rule, resistors in parallel, the resulting resistance now seen with two in parallel has to be less than the 20. So when you're doing your calculations and it comes out to more than 20, you've got a problem. If I use the 1 over RT equals 1 over R120 plus 1 over 80, and then I do the math and then flip it, I will come up with a number. Another way to do it is, if we use the other formula, which we showed, what we get is 20 times 80 divided by 20 plus 80, 16 is less than 20. That's just for the two in parallel, okay? Now we have to add the 40. So total resistance, R Thevenin, will be 56 ohms. So let's just start with our, I'm going to clean this and then start my Thevenin equivalent circuit, because what it's going to look like is this. It's going to look like some voltage, some resistance, and right now we're at 56 ohms. That leaves, what is the voltage then? For the voltage, what we need to do is we need to put our battery back in the circuit. And we had a 10-volt battery, if I recall. All right. And just grounding there so that you get used to where the zero is. Polarity, current flow. Now, interestingly enough, looking at this circuit, is there current through here? You need a complete circuit for current to flow. It's got to start out at one end and go all the way to the other side. In this case here, there is no current flow through the 40 ohm resistor, which means that voltage is only developed across resistors which allow the current to flow through it. We're going to have some voltage across the 20 ohm resistor and some voltage across the 80 ohm resistor. Now, that means that I'll be looking at a circuit that looks like that. And what I want to know is, what is this voltage here? That would be the voltage that we see for Thevenin. So let's go back to the voltage divider rule, just real quick to make the math simple. I will have 80 over 80 plus 20 times 10. Okay, so I will see 8 volts. So my Thevenin equivalent circuit is going to be 8 volts and 56 ohms. Which simplifies, this is a fairly simple one because we only have a few resistors. But now I've simplified the circuit that as you continue on in your circuit analysis and add other components to it, that you will be able to not have to worry so much about going back into your circuitry and starting to do your series and parallel combinations again. So one last time, here's Mr. Thevenin's equivalent. And what we have is an 8-volt V Thevenin, and we have a 56 ohm R Thevenin. Thanks.